Timber striker Darren Mattocks joins Ross Smith and me. Darren, let's start with those injuries. To think from the end of the Vancouver game to 1 week later, the end of that Houston game, how many guys went down? Have you ever been through anything like that in your career?
No, never. I mean, three guys substituted off just because of injury. And I'd never been in a game before where that's happened, you know, so that's really unfortunate.
What does it say about the team, though, that you guys were still able to get the result, bring a positive result back, scoreless draw, and some of the guys who, Moby Kugo, for example, hadn't played in months, and he puts in a good performance?
I mean, Caleb said it all season. The depth of this team is needed, you know, and it's going to be tested over the playoffs. You know, as you said, the guys stepped in and did really good, you know, so we're really confident whenever players stepped in, it doesn't miss a beat, you know. So as I said, it's a really good away tie in Houston, which they've been excellent at home, you know, but that sets up really good to move on.
Yeah, to wrap your head around the injuries, can you take us around how you wrapped your head around the pitch, the state of it? When you went out there for the warm-up, obviously it wasn't in a good condition. You've told us before the state of pitches you played in Jamaica. Do you go back in your mind and think of those times? Does it compare at all?
I mean, as a player, like, you never try to find excuses, you know? Like, you always go out there and try to get the job done, you know, because that's what you get paid to do, you know? But, I mean, sometimes as players, you know, it's not the same when the ball doesn't bounce so you want it to bounce, or it doesn't roll, you know? So it's different to get into a rhythm, you know. And I mean, going back to Jamaica, I remember, like, growing up, like, the pitches was dirt, grass, all in the same feeling, and we had to adjust to it, you know. And coming here to America, playing where the pitches, for the most part, is usually pretty nice, you know. So sometimes my friends make fun of me when I go back home and play, and they're like, oh, you can't play. I'm like, hey, I can't play on this no more, man. So they make fun of me, you know. But hopefully, like, you know, be back at home, you know, we know the pitch is going to be really good, you know. Yeah. So as I said, that sets us up really good against a very good Houston team.
Another big talking point, penalties in the game. You're through. We saw it in the opening. You're going through. You get a touch. That's our own angle from our guys with the Portland Timbers. When you saw that back, what's your initial thought compared to at the time? At the time, did you think definite penalty?
100%. Like, I felt the contact and I went down, you know. I'm like, in the back of my mind, I'm like, yes, this is a PK, you know. And then I went to the ref and, like, he's like, Darren, no PK. I'm like, are you sure? Like, I'm like, that's a definite PK. And he said, no, you know. I was like, I was surprised that, like, they at least didn't take a look, you know what I mean? That was a bit surprising to me that they didn't even take a look at it. But for me, it was 100% a PK.
Tough too, as well, for you in your own game to shake that off. How long does it take you as a striker, knowing you didn't get the call that should have been? Does it take you a few minutes?
It usually plays in the back of your mind, you know, but you can't dwell on it too long, you know, because the game is moment, you know. You got to be ready for each and every moment, you know, and a next moment can come right after that, you know. So, I mean, for me, I just put that in the back of my head pretty quickly, knowing it's there, you know, but you just got to move on quickly from it.
As we start to look towards Sunday, the second leg, let's give a quick reminder of how MLS playoffs work and the scenarios at play. The conference semis are a home-and-home series where the team with the most total goals advances. The tiebreaker is away goals. So essentially, we're scoreless at halftime of a 180-minute match. The scenarios: if the Timbers win on Sunday, they advance. If Houston wins, they advance. If it's a scoreless draw, the game will go to a 30-minute extra time period, and if it's still tied after that, it goes to PKs. If there's a draw with scoring, 1-1, 2-2, whatever it is, then Houston advances because of that away goal tiebreaker. Darren, you guys head into this match, of course, knowing all of that, other scenarios. How does it affect your approach?
It doesn't. Yeah. You know, like, we've been really good at home, you know, and we expect to do the same, you know. Like, we're going there for a win, be on our own fence, and know they're really excited for this game, you know. So, I mean, we are not trying to go to PKs or extra time, you know. So we just want to get the job done in 90 minutes.
Exciting brand of soccer you're playing well at Providence Park, scoring goals. Do you feel an added buzz from supporters going into the second leg?
Yes, definitely. I mean, the fans behind the team has been exceptional all season over the years. I mean, even playing against Portland back in my time in Vancouver, you know, it was always an overwhelming experience, you know, when I came here, you know. And it's really good to be on this side of the fence, I would say, you know. But yeah, I mean, we're definitely excited. Like, we, like, especially at home, I think we get the guys, most if not everyone, playing above 8, 9 or 10, you know. And I think that's going to be key in this game, you know, so we're really confident.
That's interesting to hear you say that about being an opponent and coming into Providence Park. And you guys did so, obviously, in the playoffs in 2015 as well. What was that like? I mean, take me back to, and you know, five, whatever it is, years ago. What does an opponent feel when they have to come for a big game into Providence Park?
It is massive. Just the atmosphere when you walk into the stadium and hear the Timbers, hear the chant, hear seeing the scarves waving, you know, it's nerve-wracking, you know, especially for players who have never played in such, you know, I've never played here before. And I remember my first time here, I was like, whoa, this is, you know, like, this is really amazing, you know. And that's credit to this organization. Oh, they have built this club, you know, and credit to the fans who each and every game record setting each and every solo games, and that's massive for us.
What about your individual comfort level? You've had a good run of games, you've had a good run of performances as well. What does that do for your confidence, knowing the understanding for you and what's expected from your teammates and your manager is growing with every game?
Yeah, definitely. That's, you know, that's good for me because sometimes as a player you need to get a 4 or 5 games running to really, you know, get going, and over the last couple of games that's been shown, you know, so hopefully just continue this Sunday.